How to win on Deal or No Deal. Hello, and welcome to Video Jug. Deal or No Deal's heady blend of models and probability theory has made that show a hit. Here's how to make the most of your time in the briefcase jungle. Step one, know the game. There is no skill at all involved in this game, except the ability to keep your head, so don't overthink it. Step two, know yourself. Most contestants start out aiming for a certain amount of money, but once the game is on, they bet past that amount, only to lose it all. Decide on your target sum and stick to it. Step three, know the banker. For a fictional character, he has a lot of control over your life while you're on stage, so get to know him. His buyout offer is based on the average of the dollar amounts still in play, but the banker's offer is rarely spot on. There are many theories on what his formula is, but most agree that early offers are lower than average. Step four, know your math. Specifically, the basic law of probability. Each case, and therefore each dollar amount, has an equal likelihood of being eliminated. You can know your odds at any time based on the number of cases in play. In other words, if you've got two cases in play, one low and one high, your chances of keeping the high one are 1 in 2. If there are 12 cases left and only one large amount on the board, your odds of keeping it are 11 in 12. Pretty good. Step five, stay strong. Don't lose focus. Many contestants choose no deal late in the game when they have little chance of winning. Don't be dumb. Step six, the switcheroo. If you do make it to the last case, you'll be offered the chance to switch. One myth is that switching will increase your chance to win. Not true. You have a 50-50 chance of getting the top prize either way. Step seven, go nuts. Whether you win a million or lose it all, the reason we love the show is seeing people's reactions. Make the most of your triumph or your crushing, pathetic downfall, if only for your home audience. Done.